missed some basics of Ansible in my previous sessions. Well, I'm going to cover the basics of Ansible inventory and configuration file and few other things today. Hey guys, Chanchal Bose here with another session on Ansible. Configuration for Ansible can exist in few different locations where the first file found will be used. Let me demonstrate this in this terminal. I'm in my home directory. To ascertain what is the configuration file, I'm typing the command ansible --version. Output shows the configuration file is /etc/ansible/ansible.cfg. Now let me create a file .ansible.cfg in my home directory. Now if I run ansible --version, it shows the configuration file is the file that I have just created in my home directory, that is .ansible.cfg. Now if I create a directory named dc1 in my home directory and move on to it, cd onto it, and create an empty ansible.cfg. Now let me run ansible --version. It shows the configuration file is ansible.cfg in the current folder. This demonstrates the configuration for Ansible can exist in few different locations where the first file found will be used. Let's summarize the Ansible configuration file precedence order. The search order is the following. First one is ansible_config if this environment is set. Second one in order is ansible.cfg in the current directory. Third in order is .ansible.cfg in the home directory. If none of the three is available, Ansible will take default /etc/ansible/ansible.cfg. Advantage of this, you can have multiple directories targeting different data centers like DC1, DC2, or data center 1, data center 2, data center 3, and so on. Each directory will have an ansible.cfg and inventory of associated hosts. But beware, if Ansible were to load the ansible.cfg from a world writable current working directory, it would create serious security risk. Another user could place their own config file there, designed to make Ansible run malicious code both locally and remotely, possibly with elevated privileges. For this reason, Ansible will not automatically load a config file from the current working directory if the directory is world writable. Ansible is designed to be used by a normal user for IT automation. You don't need to be root for configuring Ansible. Ansible configuration file has tons of options, and you can refer to etc/ansible/ansible.cfg as the starting point. This is the file, and this file contains good information in comments. Also refer to the documentation I have referred here. Working with Ansible inventory. Ansible inventory could be a complex topic as it has lots of options available. In our earlier exercises, I have used a simple inventory list, node 1, node 2. Ansible hosts could be grouped. Inventory file could be written in INI or JSON format. Example file in /etc/ansible/host is an INI like one of the Ansible's defaults and could be a starting point. Here is an inventory file in INI format. The headings in brackets are group names which are used in classifying systems. You can write inventory file in YAML format. A YAML version of the previous example would look like this. If you have hosts that run on non-standard SSH ports, you can put the port number after the host name with a colon in your host file itself. You can put systems in more than one group. For instance, a server could be both a web server and in a specific data center. For example, what you could create in groups that track what an application stack or a microservice, for example, database servers, web servers, etc., where a data center or region to talk to local DNS storage, etc., for example, east or west. When the development stage to avoid testing on production resources, for example, prod test. Here is an example of grouping both in INI and also in YAML format. If you are adding a lot of hosts following a similar patterns, you can do this rather than listing each host name. This is known as Ansible's globbing pattern. Ranges are inclusive. You can also define alphabetic ranges. For example, here, A colon F, which represents A to F. You can also select the connection type and user on a per host basis, just like this target localhost. Here is an example. Assigning a variable to machines, group variables can also be applied to an entire group at once. Bangalore colon vars are the variables associated with the Bangalore host group. NTP underscore server is one of the variables. There are two default groups, all and ungrouped. All contains every host. Ungroup contains all hosts that is not in any group aside from all. Every host will always belong to at least two groups. The static inventory solutions described till now not serve your needs if your Ansible inventory fluctuates over time, with hosts spinning up and shutting down in response to business demands. You may need to track hosts from multiple sources, cloud providers, LDAP, Cobbler, and/or enterprise CMDB systems. So, you'll have to pull your Ansible inventory from this external source. Since Ansible 2.4, there's an inventory plugin type to standardize the way to implement dynamic inventories. You can list all inventory plugins using the following command: ansible-doc-t inventory-l. Here, T stands for type. There is a lot of already existing inventory plugins to interface with most common vendors, that is GCP, AWS, Azure, OVH, Scalaway, and so on. A chapter on inventory could be a long one. I suggest you refer to this URL. Ansible could do magic using dynamic inventory and inventory plugin, which we'll cover while provisioning infrastructure. What is an Ansible ad-hoc command? The ad-hoc command is the one-liner Ansible command that performs one task on the target host. Here is an example, Ansible ad-hoc command to ping all hosts in the inventory file. Generally speaking, the true power of Ansible lies in playbooks. Why would you use ad-hoc tasks versus playbooks or instead of playbooks? For instance, if you wanted to power off all your lab for Christmas vacation, you could execute a quick one-liner in Ansible without writing a playbook, as shown in the second example. Third is an example to transfer a file directly to many hosts in Atlanta group. Let me show you a live demo to ping all hosts and also a live demo of install tree package in Node 1 using Ansible ad-hoc command. Ansible modules are the core units which Ansible uses to execute tasks. In our previous sessions, we have already used modules yum, service, copy, etc. To check what are the modules available, use ansible-doc-l. To check what are the parameters associated with the module, use ansible-doc-s module name. Here is a list of common Ansible modules that we use regularly. Every playbook runs set of module reflected in the output gathering facts. To see all the facts of a node, Ansible node1-m setup. If you run this command, amount of facts could be mind-boggling. Here's the sample output of setup on node 1. These facts could be used to implement conditional execution of tasks and also to get ad hoc information about any managed node. For example, just to get the IP address of the managed node, Ansible node1-m setup-a, then filter equals to Ansible underscore ETA 0, and so on. Facts gathered by Ansible from a host are key value pairs, and we can make use of any of these variables for conditional execution of a play. This will cover once we cover the Ansible conditional execution. Here is an assignment of using facts from setup variable. Write a playbook myfacts.yaml that writes to a file named /root/facts.txt in node 1, the IP address, MAC address, and kernel version of node 1. To execute this task, I'll use the variables from setup output and use those variables in conjunction with the copy module. First, run the command ansible node 1 -m setup pipeless. In the output, try to locate the string. In the output, try to locate the string MAC address, IP address, etc. like this. And similarly for kernel. Finally, once the mytask.yaml is complete, run it and see what really happens. I hope this video helped you, and if it did, make sure to give us a like. Also, don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe, ring the bell so that you, my friend, don't miss any my future tip, trick or tutorial. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys next. Until then, stay tuned and make sure you keep automating.